So we've seen how we can add things to lists by using the append command. In this case, we added a sword. And we've seen how we can remove things. In this case, we moved a duck using the remove command. And we've got our list up the top here. Okay, so that will be altered depending on the choices we make in the game. Now, what I've done here is I've added another if, elif, and else option for the user. Okay, so what will happen this time is if they select T, they will keep the sword they've already got, and they will gain a magic cup. Okay, now what we can do is we could start adding points for things inside the list. All right, so what we can do is do if, let's say, a sword in, let me tell if I spelt it correctly, in rucksack. Okay, so if sword is in the rucksack list, then we can say points equal points plus 100. Okay, and then we'll print the score out so the user knows how many points they've got. Okay, and then we'll say else, so in other words, if the sword is not in there and they've chosen the wrong option at some point in the game and lost the sword, then their points will just be whatever their points are. Okay, so we can detect if something's in the list, and if it is, we can give it points. If it's not, then we won't add any extra points. Okay, so we can test this out, and rather than going through the whole game, what we can do is if we pick the right part, here we go, so I can highlight code that I don't want to run, because I don't really want to run all this stuff because we know it works. Okay, so I'll just keep the bit in with the name. And if we go to format and then comment out region, okay, and what that will do, that will just put hash symbols, so none of this code will run. When we want to uncomment it, we just highlight and go format uncomment region, and that will just put it back so it will run. Okay, but this is just a quicker way of testing your code. So this should go straight through to the bit I want. So we'll type in our, we'll type in our name, so it goes straight through to the bit on the knight. Okay, so we have to give him the duck here so we can get the sword. There we go, he's got our sword, and there's the sword in the list. And I think in this one, this is my new one, I think if I press T, I keep the sword. Yeah, because if I press S, it removes the sword. We want to keep the sword so we can see if it will add the points on. Okay, so I'm going to press T to steal the magic cup. Okay, and there's a little error there. Okay, so I've said point rather than points. Okay, so it's saying points is not defined. There we go. So this is why it's a really good idea to test your code, because you never know what might pop up. So let's just go through that again. So we want to give him the duck, and we want to steal the magic cup. So assuming this all works, we should get 100 extra points for keeping the sword. There we go. Your score is 105, because it's detected I've got the sword. Okay. Now, again, we can retest this, and we can see what happens if we don't have the sword this time. It shouldn't give us the points. Okay, so let's try this. So the option we need to select this time is S, because you can see there, that means it will remove the sword from our rucksack. Okay, so let's try it and see what happens. D to give him the duck. And S, which should remove the sword. There we go, good, okay. So you can see there, this bit of code has gone straight through to the else, because there's no sword in our list. Okay, so therefore it hasn't given us 100 points this time. So that's how you can use your list to give yourself points in the game.